Ah, that's what it was. It's smooth acoustic. That's what I was thinking about. Well, that is actually kind of redundant, but you get the point. Hey everyone, Tappers here, and welcome back to the Paper Mario Randomizer. When we last left off, we completed the flower fields, got our fourth star, and we're headed into Tubbalubba's stronghold. And, oh, I guess I didn't need Bo for this one. And we have more hot clubbas, and don't mind the terrible joke. Okay, we have another one of those. Do I want to take these guys out? Is that close? I think it. Yeah, it's close enough. Yeah, it's like explosion like that would easily wake up everybody, but yeah. So. Fortunately, this is a case where we're actually taking on this place once we've gotten Lullabot. Oh, wait, does... I don't know if the stopwatch... I didn't grab the Sleepy Sheep, so, joke's on me, I guess. Oh, well. Oh, God, they do 4 damage. But yeah, this is kind of like one of those points where playing something like Thousand Year Door, where you have more options to dodge and avoid all damage... is a bit better, but it's kind of debatable. Oh god. Yeah, I'm not gonna fight all of them. I think where I'm at is probably fine. Oh yeah, there's more. How many more star pieces are there? I missed. I'm gonna be careful. Boing. Huh. That's strange. I actually thought there were items hidden in that one, but I guess not. But yeah, the point of, oh, Thunder Rage. I love leading enemies on. It's always great. Actually, you know what? We're just gonna power bomb because I think there's an area where I can just get. There's a heart block, I think, in the basement. At least that's kind of what I'm remembering. But, like, the point here is, if it hasn't been mentioned, after poor Stanley got eaten along with Herbert, well, actually, Herbert was already eaten that we didn't witness, but that we were kind of told about. What was it? Oh. Oh, I didn't remember you were here. That's something you definitely want to wake up to, getting blasted. wait, do I have... I did bring multi-bounce, that's right. Yeah, so actually multi-bounce is something I probably could have been using for this run, but I didn't. Is that gonna... Okay, it... Timing that doesn't... Or mistiming it still does the same amount of damage, it's just it ends the combo. Okay. But we're supposed to find out the secret to how Tubbalubba is not as invincible as it's stated. And we're supposed to, like, find some keys down here. Okay, we can actually complete Dry Ruins and maybe make this a little less awkward. Mario, nice place. Yeah, actually, the basement doesn't look too bad, although it's like there's nothing here, so it's kind of boring. Find his weak point. Something important hidden on the highest floor. Separated, hide. But you can go. Nice room. Yeah, don't fight him. He's invincible. And I've never actually fought Tubbalubba when you really can't fight him. It's always one of those weird. Oh, hello. I'm willing to bet that the last. Upgrade block is probably in Dry Ruins because there's like several areas that may have blocks. But as said before, a little sad that. Oh, okay, yeah, you just gave up. Is there one more? Oh no, it's just weird that it's like you only have like one guard on the other staircase. It just feels kind of strange. And surprisingly, that clubba is not asleep. Same with this one. But yeah, the interesting thing is that I guess because I'm gonna bring bow because I don't remember if do I have whoops. Yeah, there were only like three keys because you didn't have that many that were required. Did I have a speedy spin? That's quick change. Where was it? Oh, it was dizzy attack. That's what I was thinking of. I'm actually not going to use those. I'm going to put dizzy attack because I kind of like the blue color is kind of neat. And if I like run into somebody, I feel like I probably should use that. And you missed. See ya. It's like, I did my job. I spotted someone. But where'd they go? I could have sworn that. Oh, right. There's totally nothing hidden there. Actually, I just realized, if you have the slow go badge, which you, I think, find. Yeah, you find it in Dry Ruins. I kind of forgot about that. But you would be able to. Is this more efficient? Yeah, I actually think it is. But you would be able to deal with getting past these clubs very easily if they are sleeping. Thanks, Merlovely. That was not quite as helpful, but we'll take every bit that we can. What am I at? Level 17. Okay. So we're getting there. Careful. Grab that. I may as well grab this star piece while I can, because I can clear out the shop, and maybe I'm, like, forgetting a badge that I probably should have bought. Not to mention, I may have already cleared out the rewards. Never mind. It's like, oh my god, you actually missed. No, don't chase me into the spike wall room, or the spike floor room. So, interesting thing about this room, this is, I think, a very important room in like a speedrun sense, because you take one damage every time you get high on something. I'm assuming you cannot two-cycle this, or one-cycle that room. Oh my god. Okay, yeah, leaving him alive was probably not a good idea, and there was a Thunder Rage. Do I care about that? I don't really remember, but I have 58. Okay. You know, if I didn't know better, I would probably just, like, try and blow up the lock instead of trying to find keys, but eh, whatever. I'm just gonna go ahead and use the secret power that would. Yeah, it's kind of awkward looking, but yeah, these guys are all kind of susceptible to sleep, hence why they go for four turns, or I guess you could say five, because when they wake up, they're not going to be able to do anything. I never really knew that early on when I played this game, so I pretty much had to defeat all of them one by one. And if I had, like, known, then I'd be able to, like, manage my damage very easily. This is sort of a reason why TTYD can be, like, better, sort of, because you can just avoid damage altogether, but at the in exchange for having to time it a lot, it's a lot harder timing since you're also doing like one damage to them. This was the area that had Oh yeah, the bookcase. And yeah, there's just a secret stairway and I'm not gonna trigger that trap. No, there's no trap. It's just like, okay. That might be the last, what's it called? I can't think of the word. That's another leaf. I don't need to grab that. Getting high on something? I already forgot what I was saying. Alright, well, we got a straight hallway. Oh no, it's the hot tub. Why am I... Something fishy. Yeah, like... Hey, what's up? You know, I actually should have tried to use the spin attack. Oh, right. So, speaking of... Wait a minute, it was zero, I think, right? The slow go. Unable to run, his pace becomes very slow. But, slow enough that you'll never wake them, assuming you don't jump. Yeah, I would actually guard that too, if I'm being completely honest. Like, the only way you could probably wake them up is if you jump. I'm gonna test it out. Yeah, that is correct. And we're just gonna book it. Was I dreaming? Was that Tubba Blubba? He looked green. Like he was about to throw up or something. Nah, I don't know what I'm talking about. But yeah, we're like at 12 minutes and we've kind of already gotten to the end. Like, you could sort of say that these chapters are like really short, but ultimately it just has to do with, you also had to do Bo's Mansion and then you had to get all the way here. Oh, and then you had to do Forever Forest. So, I mean, that's fair enough, I guess. I might be in trouble. Star Spirit ran away. Suspicious in the castle. And he looked green to boot. I didn't have a... Oh yeah, you could just revoke your invincible privileges. Yeah, that would kind of suck. But... Yeah, you look... I just love... Oh my god. He's got weird... I don't remember... His eyes looking like that when they're closed. It's like there's no line or anything. It's kind of weird. Wait, hold on. Oh, okay, I am recording. It's like, I didn't even notice. It's Yaki. Faithful Che Fowler, guards possessions. Like, couldn't you just, like, put your possessions in that giant cabinet there? I mean, it's like, it doesn't have a door. Can you see me? Yeah, we are. Very honest person, aren't you? It doesn't matter what you answer because he's just gonna spill the beans. Yep. Yeah, 5 more minutes. That's how I feel now that I've changed rooms. I'm like so groggy in the sleep. Let me pop that bubble. No, okay. Yeah, this part's not even timed. And this was like a part that kind of scared me a bit, or got me tense as a kid, because you had to run away, and you also get to see how intimidating Tub of Lava can be, because he just completely shatters most of this bridge. More like a bridge too short. No, don't quote Bubsy. What the hell's wrong with you? Nope, I can't. I thought I could, like, fall down through there, but I guess I can't actually do that. And yeah, Tub of Lava... You can fight. I want to get out of here because, oh my god, the screen shaking just is... Ooh. Wait, how did he crush the other bridge? But I mean... No. I was going to say, well, actually, it makes sense. No, it doesn't. It's like, you're on the top floor and... You, like, only took out part of the bridge up top and then the lower floor. Eh, whatever. But, oh man, the Gusty Boos are here to save the day. And they brought all their Reinforcements? Is that technically... No, that's not the ones in town. That's just the guardsmen, sort of. But I guess the one thing I really like about the boos in this game are that they have extra sprites. Although they're just more resistance fightery. I don't know what to talk about. You know, now that I think about it, Tub of Lava is sort of like Bellum. Maybe that's what he was meant to be. Because Bellum was just sort of kind of a weird cat. Not really lucky cat kind of creature-ish. That looked like sort of a couch or something. And Tub of Lava, well, is a Koopa of some sort. Well, a Clubba, actually. Do you say anything? Discover a stranger to chase you, hide somewhere. I actually want to see what they have to say. Don't want to be eaten. No, I'm going to talk to the other guys. Can't stop me. What happened to them? Well, Calvin, Hobbs, Sam, Max, Freaky, and Cosgrove are all in trouble. Oh, thanks for that, Invisibo. No, he doesn't deserve the name Invisibo. It's like he was more than helpful, if I'm being honest. But yeah, now we're actually in the windmill, which is kind of relevant. What's it say? Oh yeah, no entry allowed. Really? No entry allowed. Absolutely no entry. Oh, absolutely no entry allowed. Oh, absolutely you're allowed? Okay, sure, I'm in. But yeah, now we actually find the secret to Tub of Lava's invincibleness. He doesn't have a heart, so he doesn't feel anything, so he's therefore a damage sponge. But no, actually someone did tell us. Sorry, but here we go. But yeah, this is technically the true final boss of... Oh god, he has 65. He's lame! He doesn't have, 64. But then again, now that I'm thinking about it, there's a health value I'm expecting. Does Fan Smack do more? I don't think it does. But now we have probably one of my favorite, boss tracks. I don't remember what it's called, but it's Tub of Lava's boss theme. But... you look tasty. But you can't gobble ghosts. Also, I find it weird that she laughs, but she doesn't have her fan. It's a little weird. Thanks for spilling the beans about a super attack that you're going to do. I'm almost tempted to actually see how much damage I take, but I'm... not going to do that right now because I want to be able to get as much damage as I can in and not use any items. Oh yeah, he just summons a bunch of mini hearts. I don't ask how he does that. I was going to say he's like Legion where he just summons a lot of his undead piles of flesh. I don't know. The interesting thing is it looks like he has super armor or something like that, but it's not even really that. Because it's like he barely flinches from being attacked. But then again, that might be like the wrong definition of super armor, because it's something that like DDD or Bowser would have in Smash. But oh, that was awkward looking. So, basically, you're supposed to get him to a certain health value. Oh, actually, that's good, because you're supposed to get him to... what is it? 5 HP, and then the battle just ends. But I'm going to actually get him to 0 and see if anything changes. No, nothing happens. And you don't get anything, because that was technically a part one of the boss. I should just go home with the... Is that heartbeat? So I actually have an idea, and this is a really terrible idea that I'm going to do. I don't want to deal with these Goombas, so I'm just going to get out of here. And I'm going to just go through... I'm just going to go through the gate and see what happens. If I soft lock, then I'll just redo all this and cut back. This is the right one. This is so weird. It's like... Actually, hold on. I'm going to talk to Frankie because he might have something interesting to say. My lady, did you... Oh. Okay, he didn't have anything to say. Hey! Bootler, I just let Tubba chase us. Oh, where's Bootler? Where is he right now? Oh, he's... Oh, they didn't... Oh, they just didn't... This is funny. Okay, let's see. Do I just... Yeah, he's not here, so, let me do this. Does this work? Did I? I might have softlocked myself. Okay, let's try this. I have a feeling I just softlocked myself. I didn't want to do that. Oh, there's only one. Okay, that's fine. This was a really bad idea, and I did it. Did I... How much do I have to do? A lot? Oh, okay. Yeah, he just goes right into the floor. Okay. I didn't have to redo this. I'm all good. Okay, that was kind of an odd pause. Okay, so 2-3 minutes of time wasting. Flex? Oh yeah! I need it. Oh, he didn't flex. Okay, that was weird. Oh no, he has 8 HP. Well, I think I'm gonna be getting a level up after this. But yeah, we can actually kind of... Oh, wow, I actually got the timing on that one. I thought I was a second short. Oh yeah, he had actually a pretty neat attack there. He just kind of does the slam dunk. But his injured sprite is really strange. And oh my god, I got exactly 28. Exactly what I needed. But now we get to see Softy Tubba. I'm not so visible. I said that without not even remembering. But yeah, we kind of find out the reason they did it is because he was bolt. Oh, he ate some of the white ones too, or the regular booze. Just a random leftover one. Sensitive guy in a huge body. Yeah. And it's like, wait, did we really do the right thing, especially since you're the one that started this? And it's like, why are we traveling with you exactly? Like, you're very noble-ish, but fine, I'll say yes. So I guess we... Yeah. But, okay. Well, for our efforts of freeing all the boos so that they can torment Tubba again. Ugh, this was probably not a good idea, but... I'm sorry, Scholar, but I hope things are not going to be awkward between us, especially since unless you found like a certain other role as healer. I don't even know what I'm talking about, but truth be told, we get Smooch, which is a big heal, and I don't think he's going to be happy about that. So, what are you going to do? So, it's like, after you rescue him, I think... Oh, you can actually hear the gears turning in the tower, or the lighthouse. Or, no, the windmill. It's not a lighthouse. If it was a lighthouse, it'd be a lot darker, but yeah, you never know. I'm terrified to actually see what actually happens, but... Oh yeah, Star Rod, he gets stronger, and... Yeah, this is the part where it's like, Bowser freaks out because the Invincible Tubbloa lost, so he relies on Peach to give honest answers about the toy box. I don't think there was anything else I wanted to grab there. So we're gonna use the Homeward Shroom, and... we're actually where we need to... No. We're gonna visit, Rolf and Ruff, because they have probably more items. And if they don't, then that's kind of okay too, because... We don't really need much. Oh yeah, I got that strange leaf again. I'm pretty sure I don't need any of these, but, I mean, I'm just traveling with an eight. Oh, was it just a few chapters worth? Actually, we're gonna find out. Wow. I guess it was. In that case, we're just gonna visit Koopa Koop, because he does have a couple more requests. But yeah, as I was saying, there's not as much left to do now that we're getting like all the key items. And no, this is not like going to be a 100% run. No, just not even. I mean, I'd do that over attempting to do the Boshi race in RPG. But, oh, speaking of RPG, that game's going to be probably coming out near the end of this year, and I kind of want... Wait, what'd he say? Oh, he misplaced his glasses. And, somewhere in town... Okay, that's kind of an easy one to do. Is this the beginning of town in one of the bushes? No, it was not. Just boring old glasses. Which, it's weird because they don't... Wait a minute. I already gave the picture back. He didn't have glasses when he was young, did he? I don't think he did. Well, regardless. Hopping hurt plant. What kind of saying is that? It's so weird. I don't know what he said. I want to say chapter 6 is like the last chapter that has requests. I need a tart pick me up. Fresh lime. Do I have a lime? Oh no, that might be a problem. I might have to actually look at some past footage to find out where it is. But all the same. Okay, let me see. Oh my god, all these repel. I do have a lime, yes! Okay, good. I'm so happy I held it, but maybe it's because I remembered. No. I do have lime candy, okay. It's like I could have given him that instead, and maybe he'd enjoy it just as much. But... By Wacka's bump. What's that sound? Oh, that was just upstairs. Never mind. Take this, it might be... I could have been making a count of jam and jelly, but I just opted not to. Okay, now this one I think requires... Oh no, actually, the cuckoo cookie's right here. I can try going down, Koopa Leaf, and no idea what the other is. Except, I used a different recipe. Lino Albino Dino. Okay. Albino Dino. Yeah, that sounds a lot better. And, yeah, actually, those are the quests already. The next, or the last batch has, like, one where you need to head into Dry Dry Outpost. And then you have to, like, do one of those purchase the items in order sequence. But I'm not gonna do that because next time... Well, I'm gonna look it up just to see what the remaining quests were, because I don't think there's any preparation I had to do. So, next time we're gonna deal with all of... What's this called? Dry Dry Ruins. Get the 6th Star Spirit, and that might be it. Because, like, if you look here, we only need some keys. And I want to say those might be the castle. But, yeah, like, there's not a whole lot left. So, next time, I already mentioned we're going Dry Dry Ruins. So, this has been Tappers, and I'll see you then. I am so sorry, Scholar, for what may or may not happen. That has to suck so much.